Good morning. Fall-ish.
Don't say it.
Fall-ish.
Get
feel.
Rid of that now.
Yeah, you know, it's only going to be short-lived through today and tomorrow morning. Then we quickly warm up, dealing with a little bit of showers this morning after a soggy Tuesday. We're going to dry out on your Wednesday.
Yeah, I had to close the window last night.
You had to close the
window? It was chilly.
Oh, poor Roger.
Roger.
Had to close the window.
Window.
Get a little blanket, Raji.
Thank you.
Okay, let's take a look what we got going on. As we mentioned, we're still dealing with some morning showers right now. Watching some earlier thunderstorm activity becoming a little less intense over through the shorelines of Lake Huron. This is pretty much the end of the wet weather that you're going to see, mainly overcast skies through the morning into the afternoon. We'll start to deal with a little bit of partly cloudy skies, that is. Right now, some of the heavier rain currently moving its way over the waters of Lake Ontario, but also seeing some fairly wet roads through St. Catharines, Hamilton, over through the downtown core and into Oshawa. So with today, the winds, they're going to be quite gusty and also quite cool. They're going to be out of the northwest. Right now they're out of the west at about 17 kilometers per hour, but you can see that northwesterly over to Muskoka and Goderich. So that brings in that fallish kind of feel, brings down the temperature. Temperatures right now, 20 at the island, 19 over at Pearson, 19 into Oshawa, 19 over in Oakville. That doesn't seem bad, but today your high will be below seasonal. We'll see a high just around 22 degrees. Through the overnight, cool again. Tomorrow, though, warmer through the afternoon, up to 26, mainly clear skies. Increase the cloud into Friday night, but a nice warm day as well with a daytime high of 27. Let's look at your forecast. Over to you, Carrie.
All right, thanks, Frank. Well, northbound 410 approaching Courtney Park and the collectors, just the left lane is getting through right now, and this is all for cleanup from an earlier tractor trailer rollover, and delays are starting to build now as you approach that problem. Make sure if you're coming off the eastbound 403, you get into the express lanes onto the northbound 410, and you can bypass these delays right now. No word yet when all the lanes are going to reopen, but they have removed the tractor trailer from the scene, so it's a little bit of improvement there in the last little while. But again, North 410 approaching Courtney Park and the collectors, two right lanes remain closed for this cleanup. Looks like construction has wrapped up now. Westbound on the 401 through Morningside and the collectors, all lanes are getting through and not spotting any delay through that stretch anymore. Looks like a pretty good drive as you make your way across the city on the westbound 401. Coming down the southbound 400, that's in great shape as well from Barrie down to the 401. And still a lightly traveled drive on the QEW in both directions. A bit of wet weather, but it looks like that's easing off for the most part. Still looking good on the Gardner into and out of the city as well. In the east end of Toronto, Danforth, that is still shut down in both directions between Pape and Jones. That is all for a police investigation. We have more details on that coming up in our newscast. With that, I'll throw it back to Mel.